Hey KISS fans, John B. Good here. Gonna do a little bit of a different video today than I usually do. Peter Criss, 1978 solo album. Lots of reviews out there, so I'm not gonna do one on the album. Just gonna do it on this one song. I Can't Stop the Rain, last song on the album. And to me, it's always been a standalone track. It just doesn't sound like anything else that's on this record. I mean, you got Easy Thing, and you got Kiss the Girl Goodbye. But I Can't Stop the Rain is just, to me, a masterpiece. It's the masterpiece on the album. And it was written solely by Sean Delaney. Sean was asked to write a couple songs for Peter Criss's solo album because he was short a couple tracks. And Sean was busy working on Gene's album, you know? And Sean's like, well, you know, I'm kind of in the middle of doing this, but yeah, I can come over and help out. So he came over and, you know, wrote a couple songs with Peter, including this masterpiece. To me, I Can't Stop the Rain is Peter Criss's best vocal delivery of any song he's ever done in Kiss and out of Kiss. It's just great. And it never grows old on me. The song itself is, to me, it's about, you know, it was written by Sean Delaney, but I always, you know, envisioned Sean writing that for Peter, trying to speak through him, because the song's about loss, you know, I Can't Stop the Rain, Here It Comes Again. Peter was going through a lot of stuff, you know, end of 77, 78, you know, had a car accident, almost, you know. He was very lucky. It was very lucky that that wasn't a fatal car accident. Can you imagine if Peter Criss would have been killed in a fatal car accident in 1978? What would have happened? That's a topic for another show, but what would have happened? I hate to say that, but I mean, there's been a lot of tragedies in rock and roll, and that could have easily happened. Anyways, getting back to this song, the orchestration, the strings and everything, they just build this song up so strong towards the end. I mean, let me just cut in really quick here. Listen to those vocals. And it takes a witch to curse that goddamn sky. I think that Casablanca, Neil Bogart, and whoever else is involved or was involved with what songs were chosen to be released as a single. Whoever was in charge of picking out the single made a horrible mistake, in my opinion. You Matter to Me, it's a great song, but it doesn't beat this. I guess maybe they were just apprehensive. Maybe this was too much of an easy listening, you know, dive. But You Matter to Me, I mean, that's AM radio. And this is AM radio greatness right here. I think it would have went up the charts, especially on AM radio. But I think it would have went into the FM radio charts as well. I think it was a strong song. And the last note I'll leave on is, what if Sean Delaney had produced this album like he wanted to? You know, Peter wanted to run out and get Rod Stewart's manager. But what if Sean Delaney would have produced Peter's album? I think it would have came off a lot better. I think that Sean knew how to tap into the Peter Criss magic. And this song and the album, but the song, I Can't Stop the Rain, is just magic. All right, guys. John, be good here. Have a great one. See you in the next video.